You speak to wrapping the community around the district. Oklahoma City Public Schools are in areas where people often feel that the city neglects them. I mean, in some places you can't even, you know, throughout the city, you can't even catch a bus after 7 o'clock. There's been a lot of investment in downtown Oklahoma City. Many parents, many residents say the community, the city needs to pay more attention, but how do you convince that city, that community to do so?
Well, you know, one of the things, when I first started looking into Oklahoma City during the search process, the first thing that jumps out at you is what's happened here with the MAPS projects. I mean, you know, three different tax initiatives that the voters have approved. And of course, the second one was MAPS for Kids. So I think to a large extent, this community has already spoken out and they're supportive of the students' education and educational needs. But I think the key is that I don't know that the community knows or thinks or feels that they're a part of the equation or wants to have ownership. You know, this is our legacy. I look around this room. There's a whole bunch of adults in this room. We all own a piece of this. It is our collective responsibility to ensure our students' success. So people ask me, how can we be a part of the process? Well, first of all, be a part of this great conversation that's going to start in November and continue on through May, maybe even into June. And bring your voice to the table. But at the same time, you have time, talent, or treasure. And so how can you contribute to your schools? I would love to see every one of our schools be adopted by a business, a nonprofit organization, and a church. We have to have our schools open 7 days a week, 12 hours a day, and we have to extend the services in our communities through the schools. They have to be part of the community. And so I think by doing that, we can create more of a feeling of community in our school system.